By seeing the title, you must have understood now what I am going to discuss today. But before starting the video, we need to know what is space station. It is known as the orbital station that orbits around the Earth. It is capable of hosting human crew for extended period of time, do research and observe surrounding space. It has a docking port where other spacecraft can dock and transfer astronauts, equipment, supplies. In 1971, Soviet Union was the first to launch a first space station, Salyut 1. Then Skylab was the first American space station launched in 1973. Again, Soviet Union launched the Mir station in 1986, which only orbited around the Earth till 1998, when International Space Station joined him in the space party. Like Skylab, Mir also met a watery demise in 2001. And since then, ISS has been orbiting alone for long 20 years. But from June 2021, ISS has a new neighbor, China's Tianhe space station. Tianhe is expected to be completed by 2022, once all the components have been launched and assembled. Today in this video, we will show how the Tianhe is different from the ISS. First of all, total 16 countries involved with ISS, but China is the only country with Tianhe. International Space Station has total 16 components, while Tianhe has 3 modular components. Modular means it can be divided into different module or segment. Like in one module, astronauts can stay. Here it is the docking module. Now here you are seeing the service module from where the space station is controlled. The next point is ISS is a fourth generation project, while Tianhe is a third generation project, which is very cost effective. ISS has a total habitable volume of 13,696 cubic feet. According to the NASA website, the ISS usually hosts 6 astronauts at a time, but at some points there have been more people on board. For example, a record was set in 2009 when a total 13 people were on board ISS at once. Tianhe will have a total habitable volume of 3,884 cubic feet and is designed to accommodate 3 astronauts. It does not mean Tianhe is inferior in quality. It has the latest technology as well. Around a dozen missions will be needed to complete the Chinese station by 2022. The ISS meanwhile required more than 30 missions to assemble, with construction beginning in 1998. Now let's look at the other differences between these two. From most locations on Earth, assuming you have clear night sky, you can easily see the ISS in naked eyes. It looks like a bright star coming from west and disappearing to east. NASA has its own application and website which give us real-time location of International Space Station as well. If you tell them your location and subscribe to email alert, they will alert you once it passes by your location. Similar like ISS and NASA, China was researching on space station in last decade. They sent 2 space stations previously known as Tiangong 1 and Tiangong 2. Now after all the trial and research, finally they sent the Tianhe space station. Till today, astronauts from 19 countries visited ISS, but none from China. Chinese astronauts are not allowed to board the International Space Station, even though it is one of those countries beside USA and Russia to send astronauts to the space. Because American law prohibits NASA to allow any Chinese fund for International Space Station and its space program, ISS will be decommissioned in 2020 and is supposed to extend to another 6 years. The main problem is in its solar panel, which needs replacement with newer one. Tianhe has 1/5 of the weight of the ISS but capable of producing same power for the space station. Since ISS will be completing its time span in 2022 and it can be further extended to 2028, the question is, will China be the only country to have an operational space station on the orbit? What do you think? Please tell us your opinion in the comment section. That is all for today. Thank you for watching our video. We will come back in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.